Hello, I'm William Short of Hurstwic, and this is another in our series of Viking combat sparring videos. Once again, we will be showing you a sparring exercise based on a historical Viking Age battle described in the sagas of Icelanders. We do these sparring exercises to allow us to experience as closely as possible Viking Age fight situations. If you haven't seen the first video in this series, I recommend that you watch it now, since it explains our sparring conventions and the use of the three-hit rule. Honor was central to Viking society. Dishonor needed to be avenged, which could well lead to a revenge killing in return. Sometimes the cycle of revenge killings built to the point where one side felt that the only way to restore lost honor was to kill every man in the opponent's family. And one way this was accomplished was by setting the family longhouse afire with the family inside. Women and children were allowed to escape unharmed, and then the burners would wait outside the door to cut down any of the householders who tried to escape the smoke and flames. The sagas tell of many such burnings, but perhaps the most well-known is the burning of Njálf and his family, alive in their home. The tactic seems to be an effective one. Why should the burners enter the house and fight the householders in their stronghold when they can wait leisurely outside until the heat and the smoke of the fire drive the panicked householders one at a time out through the bottleneck of the door where they can be easily cut down? Imagine the mindset of the householders inside. Behind you, smoke and intolerable heat threaten to kill you. Outside, where cool, sweet air awaits, are warriors who wait eagerly for the opportunity to slaughter you to avenge earlier attacks. Yet these are men who have killed your family members, and the desire to slay even one of them before you die is nearly overwhelming. The door is narrow and only one householder at a time can pass through. How do you time your escape? What do you do to prepare your way? And if you're a burner waiting outside for that man to run out, what do you do to ensure that he has no chance of escape? The sagas say that long weapons were used, such as spears and two-handed axes. The householders used them to try to clear a way through the burners, and the burners used them to try to force the householders back into the flames. Projectiles were thrown, such as spears and anything else that came readily to hand. Skarphéðinn threw a tooth which gouged out an eye of one of the burners. In this video, we set up the burning longhouse situation outdoors, using a wood pile and some garden structures to represent the door of the longhouse. Inside, facing the camera, the householders try to make their escape from the flames. Outside, with their backs to the camera, the burners wait in readiness. And so here, the Viking Age fight to escape a burning longhouse. Surprisingly, in this round, the householders made few attempts to escape, and they didn't seem effective at coordinating their efforts. For example, they didn't much use their projectile weapons to cover the escape of one of the other householders. Meanwhile, the burners were very effective at using projectiles and long-range weapons to keep the householders at bay, trapped up in the house, where they had few opportunities to escape, as described in the sagas. We also ran the scenario indoors, in our training room, using an interior door to represent the door of the burning longhouse. We also stacked the deck against the householders by having only one householder trying to escape while many burners waited outside for him. This required the householder to be much more aggressive in order to succeed. After Christianity was adopted in the Viking Age, the sanctity of a church was accepted, but in a different sense than the sanctity of a heathen temple. Householders who reached the sanctuary of a church expected no further attacks. And so in this round, we adopted that concept. Householders who reached the sanctuary of the further Pell in our training room were considered safe. And so here, another fight to escape a burning longhouse.
Oh,
Robin appears to have received several solid hits in his attempt to reach sanctuary. Here's another round of the same burning longhouse scenario, but this time the householder has a different plan. This round was shot using multiple cameras, as described in an earlier video in this series. Two cameras record the points of view of the fighters, and a third camera records the point of view as seen by an observer from the side. And so here, yet again, a Viking Age fight to escape a burning longhouse. In the sagas, it was not often that any of the householders survived the burning, so Robin's experience was typical. Yet there are examples in the sagas of clever men escaping the fire, such as Gisla saga, or bold men escaping the flames, such as Njal's saga. Matthew's success in this round was not typical. He was extremely aggressive, bursting out through the doorway before the burners could organize their attack against him, and finding a way through the burners that often put them in each other's way. He was very effective with his use of weapons, an axe in each hand. As the sagas tell us, it is often the bold man who is successful in the fight.